Okay, I know this happens to a lot of us, that there is a missing font in the document, like this one, for example. There's a missing Garamond Premier Pro semi-bold, and you don't want it there. So how do you find out where it is? Well, this is a short document. There's not that many pages in it. It's a template from InDesign Secrets. So I could, you know, probably scroll through here and look for the dreaded pinking. That is the default composition highlighting that InDesign applies when fonts are missing. So like right here, there's a bad boy. I'll click on it and zoom in a few times. And you can see up here in the control panel that the font is missing because it has brackets. Now, the fastest way to find these guys is to use the Find Font dialog box. And you may have seen there was a button that would have led me directly to there when I opened up this document and I got the missing font message. But you can just come up here and choose Type Find Font. It would be a really great idea if you would create a custom keyboard shortcut to this, because you'll probably be using it a lot in your work with InDesign. So here's the missing font. Now, the main thing I wanted to show you was, well, I've been using it, so it's already showing. But typically when you open this up, if you select the missing font, the one with the yellow triangle, it doesn't give you that much information other than what do you want to replace it with. But you might want to find out where it's being used. And to do that, you could choose Find First and then Find Next and so on one by one. Or click the More Info button down here, and then you'll see lots of information about where is that font being used? How many characters is it being used for? You know, sometimes the missing font is just being used for one character that you forgot to switch out. This one is not being used that often, just 31 times. It's used in one style called lead-in. And then it tells you the pages that it's on, including the pasteboard. So let's go ahead and fix the style. So I'll click here and open up the character style panel, because I know lead-in is the character style that is accidentally using semi-bold. So I'll click here, and instead of semi-bold, I want to change it back to the Adobe Garamond Pro, and we'll just say regular. Let's leave it at regular. And now that's all done. And do you remember there's some text in the pasteboard too, it said. So I'm zooming out to see where it is, or I could go back to Find Font and just click Find Next. There it is. I don't need that at all. That's probably just a test over there in the pasteboard. I'll delete that. And then the final one, I'm really not seeing any pinking. Are you? So let's come back to Find Font. But before I do that, what I like to do is to zoom in really closely, like with Command or Control 2, that'll zoom in to 200%, and then go to Find Font. Because when you say Find Next, it'll center it in the screen, and it's a lot easier to see when you're zoomed in. So I'll select this. There's only one more character being used on page 11, Find First. Get this guy out of the way. Ah, there it is. I'll click Done so we can take a look at it. It's just a space before a return. Sometimes another tip is to, when you say Find the Next One and notice that it selects it, then you can go right to the Edit menu and choose Edit in Story Editor, where you'll see the same text selected here. Sometimes it's a little easier to see in Story Editor because you're not looking at any formatting. So if the bad boy character is in a very light font, a very small font, sometimes it's easier to see in Story Editor. And there you can decide what to do with it. In this case, I'll just delete it. And now when we look at Find Font, no horrible yellow triangles. Yay! So that's the fastest way to find missing fonts in your document, is to use the Find Font dialog box, especially looking at the More Info section that's usually hidden. And that way you can learn much more information about the font being used, where it's being used, how many characters, and so on. Hey, I hope you found this tip helpful. Be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com for thousands of InDesign articles, to listen to our podcast, and to download a free sample issue of our monthly magazine called InDesign Magazine. Thanks for learning with us.